Welcome to EPG Pathshala. This is Dr. Ankush Ambardar from Department of Tourism and Hotel Management, Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra. Today, I'll be taking up a component from tourism and hospitality industry, that is hotel front office operations and management. In this module, we will be taking care of concept of registration and process of registration. Today, we'll be talking about front office operations and management, and in this quadrant, we'll be taking care of guest registration, its meaning, process, concept of guest registration, pre-registration, registration, allotting the rooms to the guests, taking the billing instructions, issuing welcome card and room key, fulfilling special guest requests, completing official records like various forms and formats, registers maintained at front office, and lastly, dealing with the summary part. We'll start up with introduction. Registration begins with the warm welcome by commissioner, bell personnel, receptionist, and other hotel employees who come in contact with the guest before and during the check-in process. It is always preferred that the guest may be addressed by his or her name, as it extends a personal touch and warmthness. Registration is done both for walk-in guests and reserved guests. Majority of guests, especially in peak seasons, come with prior reservations. The receptionist finds registration simpler and smoother when they have accurate and complete information about the guests. The receptionist also acts as a mediator between hotel management and the guests. All kinds of complaints, suggestions, advices, etc., are handled by reception, and after the approval of the management, the guests are answered accordingly. In case management wants to offer some special facilities in case of regular guests or as per seasonal promotions, discounts, then the receptionist is informed about the same and reception conveys the same to the concerned guests. Concept of guest registration and process of registration. Meaning of registration. Registration is a term given to the entire procedure followed by the hotel authorities on the arrival of the guests to confirm the stay of the guest at the hotel. Registration is a function under arrival stage of guest cycle and is even termed as check-in process. It becomes important to register guests at the time of arrival operationally and legally. Registration process helps in satisfying the legal requirements for the guests coming to the hotel with or without prior reservation to stay in the hotel. The registration is done for walk-in guests, free individual travelers, FITs, as well as group inclusive tours, that is GITs. The process involves coordination from all other subsections of front office like bell desk, reservations, lobby, etc. Registration includes completing the formalities, allotting the room, preparing the C form for all foreigners, etc. It is not mandatory for a guest to fill up the registration card in his or her own handwriting, but every individual adult name is taken down along with the signature. A hotel is required to keep all the information recorded to the guest registration card, register maintained for 1 year. The process also is helpful in knowing the hotel number of guests staying in the hotel on a particular night. Retention charges can easily be charged from no-show guests who didn't turn even after reserving room with the hotel. Most importantly, the process of registration also makes the guest abide by the rule and regulations of the hotel. Now coming to the other point, that is pre-registration. At the time of reservation, guests provide all the relevant information, and at the time of check-in, he, she will not have to wait at the front office to complete the formalities. The registration activities which take place before the actual arrival of the guest are called pre-registration. The guest registration card can be kept ready in advance by the reception staff from the information furnished by the guest at the time of reservation. In case of an automated hotel using property management system, PMS, Registration cards can be prepared with a single command, and the printouts can be received and further slotted them in registration racks alphabetically. At the time of check-in, the guest checks the registration card to see if all the information filled is correct and up to date and signs the registration card. The pre-registration normally involves filling of guest registration card, including room number, rate, and creation of a guest folio along with billing instructions. The credit card details of the guest are also entered in the guest folio. The room number is generally allocated in case of VIPs and other special guests. It is not advisable to block the room for every expected guest due to guest late arrival, cancellation, or even amendments, and sometimes guests may request for room change. The pre-registration tasks are performed manually. The pre-registration tasks are performed manually in non-automated and semi-automated systems at front office. In case of computerized system of front office, all expected guest rooms numbers can be allotted automatically. Moreover, with the help of PMS, all reservation requests can be automatically converted into registration of guests. At times, hotels provide free pickups from airports or railway stations for all expected guests, and the registration process can be completed during pickup by the hotel staff, and on arrival at the hotel, guests are taken straight to their rooms. In some luxury hotels, the registration formalities may be completed in guest rooms only for saving time and lasting impression on the guests. The pre-registration of a group saves a lot of hustle, not only for the group members, tour leaders, hotel staff, but also for other guests. A large group requires more attention of reception, and assigning rooms may take a lot of time. The room numbers are mentioned against the names of the group members on the group's rooming list, and all the keys are handed over to the group leader or the tour leader along with the rooming list. Tour leader further hands over the keys to the guests and may even change room as per guest preferences. The final rooming list returned by the tour leader to the reception is kept in the hotel record and further shared with bell desk for luggage handling. In next, the complete process of registration. The registration of a guest is done at the reception. The arrival and departure takes place throughout the day and night in large cities. The reception department operates round the clock in three shifts. Guests arriving at any time of the day might have prior reservation and other walk-ins. Some of them may be VIP, regular, or with different temperaments, and most of them tired after long journey and prefer to be attended. Immediately after allotting a room of their choice, every guest checking in is important and must be extended personalized attention. All guests above the age of 18, whether Indian or foreigner, must sign the registration register or card. The registration of a guest may be divided into two: pre-registered guests, that is guests with advance reservations, and walk-ins. Walk-ins are those guests which come directly to the hotel without reservation. The expected arrival list is received from room reservation department every day in the evening for the following day. The senior receptionist finds out the room position by adding expected departures to the available vacant rooms, and from the expected arrivals are deducted. After knowing the room position, senior receptionists blocks rooms for VIPs, CIPs, groups, regular guests, etc. Whoever fills the registration card, but it's mandatory that the guest signs on the card. The moment guest signs the registration card, it is not only confirms that all the information written in the card is correct to the best of the knowledge of the guest, but it also completes the contract between hotel and guest. The hotel is not responsible for guests' valuable but a free of cost locker facility is provided for guests' valuables. Most hotels even mention rules and regulations of the hotel on the registration card above the guest's signature column. The guest is liable to pay the room rate and is required to abide by the rules and regulations of the hotel. The hotel is also obliged to provide the amenities and other in-house facilities to the guest for entire contract period. The check-in process can be done in any of the following ways: non-automated check-in, guest registration, register, guest registration card, and automated check-in. So we'll take guest registration, register first. So when it comes to guest registration, register, before the introduction of PMS in front office operations, hotels were maintaining a ruled register for guests to fill up at the time of registration. The guest registration register is also called as Red Book. The registers were ruled for the ease of guest, so that the guests know what information has to be filled up by him or her in which column. And few columns at the end were used for office to use, consisting of information like room number, rate, special requirements, etc. But nowadays, the register is quite out of place, and only few small hotels may be seen using register for registration of the guests. Some hotels use loose pages instead of guest registration registers and are called as F forms. Now, second is guest registration card. So when it comes to guest registration card, most of the hotels maintain registration cards even if they are automated. The registration is done in card form, and generally two copies are made of the card with carbon paper. One carbon is kept for office records, and the signed copy, second copy, is attached with guest bill folio for reference and for checking and comparing guest signature as and when required. C form is separately filled for foreign guests and is later sent to FRRO office, that is Foreign Regional Registration Office. The registration card records information related to guest in his or her stay, like name, company, address, number of rooms required, passport details, visa details, stay details, etc. Automated check-in, on the other hand, in case of computerized check-in procedure, the guest only has to sign on the registration card and has not to write various details like name, company, address, nationality, etc. The reservation record maintained in the electronic form can be converted into the guest registration card, and the process of recording more information can continue. The information recorded at the time of reservation can be altered at the time of check-in. In some developed hotels, the check-in process can be completed by computers without receptionist for both reserved or walk-ins. Computers can take advance for stay electronically, and even the electronic key can be dispensed by the computer to the guests. This helps in saving time and manpower cost in advanced countries. Computerized check-in may be economical, but it lacks in personal touch and courtesy, which is essential for hotel industry. Next, allotting a room to a guest. While the guest has checked in, and after the filling registration card, the receptionist, after checking with the guest's preferences, selects a room from the room chart. Room chart helps to know the status of the rooms, and accordingly, a suitable room is allotted to the guest. The room chart needs to be updated for any further discrepancies. The allocation of rooms is done only after actual arrival of the guest, but for VIPs, CIPs, groups, regular guests, etc., expected to check in, rooms are allotted in advance, and all these allocated rooms are blocked on the chart as well as in the system, so that the same rooms are not allocated to other guests. In case of groups, airline crews, rooms are blocked and keys are kept ready. The group leader fulfills the arrival formalities and takes the room keys from the front desk or lobby manager. The group leader is handed over the rooming list against each member's name. This rooming list is kept at the reception for records, and same list is enclosed with C form to FRRO. In case of foreign guests, the CRIV members may be given room keys directly after getting pre-registered cards signed. Next point, taking the billing instructions, which is one of the most important part. At the time of check-in, the receptionist notes down the billing instructions if that is not intimated at the time of booking. A guest may select one or more than one mode of settlement of bills like cash, credit card, charge card, traveler's checks, bill to company, etc. Sometimes guests prefer to deposit advance towards their account. The advance received is credited to their bill folio and the guests are issued a proper receipt. These guests must be intimated on time before their advance deposits gets exhausted. Unknown and scanty baggage guests are requested to pay in advance, preferably for the entire stay. A guest paying cash at the time of check-in is likely to have no post status in the hotel's sales outlets. They are requested to settle all other bills in cash. The intimation of same is given to all point of sales in the hotel at the time of check-in of those guests. Next, issuing the welcome card and room key. Once the formalities of registration, billing, etc. have been completed, the receptionist issues a welcome card to every guest. The welcome card provides information regarding various facilities offered by a hotel. Welcome card is also called as key card. Normally, receptionist recognizes all the guests, but new arrivals in the previous shifts may not be recognized by all the receptionists, and the welcome card may be asked from a guest requesting for room key during the stay in the hotel. Even at other point of sales in hotel, a guest may be asked to show the welcome card at the time of billing. The room key is handed over to the bellboy who escorts the guests along with baggage. Nowadays, for the utmost safety of guests, electronic key is issued to the guest. The electronic key is even called as key card. It is preferred that a guest drops the key in the key drop box as it's easy to make another key for the guest at any moment of time. Next, fulfilling the special request of guests. At the time of registration, while registering the guest, it has to be ensured that all special requests made by the guest are acknowledged and honored. Some common special requests made by guests may be location of the room, size of the bed, interconnected rooms, etc. Few guests may be particular about view from their balcony or window plane. Physically handicapped may demand wheelchair or other aids, and obviously a handicap room with majority facilities as per need of a special guest. A cot babysitter is also desire of young couples. Important guests of the hotel can be served with complimentary fruit basket, boutique of flowers, drinks, cookies, etc. All these requests are to be taken care by hotel without further reminder from the guests. Next, completing the official records. Once the guest has been assigned room and his her desires are met, the front office tends to complete all official records in its statutory requirement that all arrivals and departures are recorded in the arrival and departure register, which is even known as A&D register. This register is kept for any further references. The C forms are also recorded in A&D register as well. For all foreigners, the C form needs to be filled and a copy to be sent to local FRRO officer, generally within 24 hours. The registration cards are updated in the system or registers. The folios are created for further transaction to be held by the guest during the stay. All complimentary coupons related to food and beverage, valet service, etc. are prepared, and information about check-in is given to various point of sales in the hotel. Some mandatory important registers used for registration. Number one, guest registration register. In this register, following formalities have been noted down. For example, date of registration, name and address of the guest, nationality, guest arrived from, proceeding to, time of arrival, expected date and time of departure, type of room, number of pax, booking taken by, and the billing instructions. Second form is guest registration card. In this card, generally, the information taken is the number of the guests, name of the guests, and the surname of the guest. Nationality of the guest, date of birth of a guest, designation of a guest if from company, date of marriage anniversary, address of the guest, guest arrived from, and proceeding to details, type of accommodation required, number of pax, purpose of visit, date and time of arrival, expected date and time of departure, rate, plan, and mode of payment, that is credit card, BTC, or any other. Newspapers, magazines for foreigners only have to be taken down on those formats. For office use, passport details of the guest with the number of passport, place of issue of passport has to be taken on. And lastly, remarks are to be given. Further, date of expiry of passport, date of arrival in India, duration of stay in India, and type of visa has to be taken down on the format. The visa number, the date of issue of visa, the place of issue of visa, and the validity of visa has to be taken care of, whether employed in India or not. If in case a guest is employed in India, registration number of India has to be taken with place of registration, date of registration, and address in India, if any. And lastly, the format states, I agree to release my room by 12 noon of the day of departure. Should I fail to check out, I authorize the management to pack and remove my belongings to the hotel, and the confirmed reservation is given. Guest signature is taken on the form. Signature of GSA, who has taken the registration of the guest, is taken on the format. Next is C form. Any hotel which is checking in a foreign guest has to fill C form, and the C form contains various information like number of the form, the name of the hotel, the name of the foreigner, which has to be taken from the passport, number of persons in the family, if accompanying the guest, nationality of the guest, which is once more taken from the passport only, the number of the passport, the date of issue of the passport, place of issue of the passport, registration number of the person, place of registration, and date of arrival in hotel, and the time of arrival. Date and place of arrival in India, and the place where the guest has arrived from has to be taken down on C form. And further, the guest is proceeding to that even has to be taken on the C form. Mode of transport used by the guest has also to be written down on C form. Address in India, other than a tourist, can be taken down on the form. Purpose of visit of a foreigner has to be taken down. Date of departure from hotel has to be taken down. Whether employed in India has to be checked by the guest. Number, date and place of issue of visa and its validity has to be noted down. Permanent home address of the guest has to be noted down. Further, the C form is signed by the manager in charge of the shift so that it can be further sent to FRRO's office, which could be a local police station nearby to the hotel if the hotel does not fall into a major city. The next form which we deal is arrival and departure register. In this register, we take details such as address of the guest, company of the guest, name of the card registered in the hotel, date and time of arrival, airport station and arrival, date and time, purpose of visit, probable duration of stay in India, room number given to the guest, pax which are accompanied with the guests, room rates, probable date of departure from the hotel, passport number and place of issue of the guest, nationality of the guest, time of departure of the guest, and departure is given to be in person. Next format which is prepared is group or crew sheet. Well, it is an important format which is filled for groups and crews and details such as the flight, the arrival date, the departure date of the guest is to be noted down on that. Further, the room number, the nationality of the crew members, the passport details, the date of issue, the validity of the passport has to be taken down on that format. In last, to summarize the same, providing room to a guest is an important function of the hotel management. Reception plays a vital role in providing rooms to guests with general rules and regulations of the hotel and meeting all legal aspects. The registration process is even called as check-in of the guest. The registration process includes welcoming of the guests, escorting a guest to room front desk, filling of various formats like registration cards, C form for foreigners, billing instructions, understand and providing some special requests of guests for special arrangements like VIPs, CIPs, handicaps, regular guests, so on and so forth. Registration does not only mean to provide desired room, but even to satisfy guests with all means. Registration records are to be maintained for operational purposes as well as for legal checks held from time to time. A hotel room status can be known at a point of time only when proper registration has been made and records are updated in the system followed by the concerned hotel property. Thank you for watching EPG Pathshala.